made it a long way since we're studying the origins way back in the reaches of time and space, from the Big Bang and the earliest coalescence of subatomic particles into the smallest, earliest, hottest atoms. And we saw how these eventually grouped together due to the gravitational force and ultimately swirled into a clumps of mass spread out through the universe known as galaxies. Is only 5 billion light years away, the appearance of the cosmos can clearly be seen. Galaxy filaments, each containing millions of galaxies, are the largest structures that we can observe in the universe. All galaxies lie along these filaments. Successive generations of you. substantial amount of gravity, located at the center of many galaxies, if not all of them. So we also talked about stars, and how they evolve and either go out with a bang, if they collapse in on themselves, or simply fade out with a whimper. And of course, the big enough ones can really collapse in on themselves and form the most mysterious objects we know exist, black holes. So we've gotten all the way down to our star. But I'm gonna skip over that. And I wanna look at the celestial body closest to us. In fact, so close to us that we live on it. This is our spaceship, carrying us through the universe, and its satellite, the Earth-Moon system. So in the beginning, the Earth was an incandescent mass that slowly began to cool, allowing the continents to emerge and acquire their current form. Many drastic changes took place during the early years. Our blue planet has still not stopped changing. And here it shows a nice depiction of the thin, colorless, if maybe faintly blue, veneer that we call the atmosphere. This tiny, tiny shell. Is what is the ocean of oxygen and nitrogen and carbon dioxide that we swim and exist in, that we breathe, that we depend on to survive. Spaceship is really made of, what its history is, and what it actually is doing in the universe as it whirls, as we whirl around the sun every year. The Earth is known as the blue planet because of the color of the oceans that cover two-thirds surface. This planet is the only one where the right conditions exist to sustain life. Actually, it's the only one that we know of that has evolved to such a degree that actually it's not just life too, it's more cosmic in significance. Because it's the only one that has developed an atmosphere that allows things to grow, things that evolved to manipulate the environment consciously, which is another abstract level of development and complexity that does not exist anywhere else in the solar system. And perhaps the universe, but not likely. So in essence, we are a part of this planet, the most complex part of it, and therefore, the planet is the most unique, the most novel, the newest, most exciting place we could possibly be, because we're here. north and south towards the points of the axis of rotation. The points that are less and less directly facing the sun as it rotates every day. The radiation and the warmth from the sun don't hit it as directly, and therefore it's more likely to ricochet off and bounce and not absorb. And so it traps all the cold temperatures. Or rather, the cold temperatures aren't heated up by direct radiation. So it gets colder and colder. We have the tropical zone, which is directly on the equator. Further north and away from the equator and south is the temperate zone. And of course, the polar zone. Now, just like we drew the sun the other day, I might make a video about drawing this one too, because it's pretty interesting. I mean, we live on a giant rotating ball of lava that churns iron in the core. It creates a magnetic field that prevents us from being fried by the powerful solar bursts of radiation from the nuclear furnace that warms and gives life. Is constantly boiling liquid metal. Constantly boiling. Of course, the rocks are much heavier in the mantle because, like common sense experience would dictate, heavier things sink to the bottom of liquid mediums. So, and then the mantle is liquid metal, and the outer crust is the densest, it's the densest part of the planet. Interestingly enough, you would think the center is, but I guess because the heat keeps it from condensing into, well, as dense of a material as the crust. So here we go. How far have we reached? Mount Everest is 30,000 feet, which is 8.8 kilometers. Offshore drilling has even gone deeper, further away from the crust than that, at 12.5 kilometers. And ocean drilling is not even registering, unimportant, unless the, of course, when the
Reservoirs.
behaves like a huge giant bar magnet and has a magnetic field with two poles. It's from all the iron and nickel in the core and its electroconductivity. But the magnetism, the field, varies. Conduits for the material that amount.